Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and covers section 2.2, part 3 on properties of inverses, simplifying matrix expressions, and solving matrix equations. I'll walk through lots of example problems to help you understand these concepts. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can highlight and fill in as you watch this video. Let's begin by learning four properties of matrix inverses. We're going to assume that A and B are n by n invertible matrices and that R is a scalar. Our first property tells us that the inverse of the inverse of a matrix is the matrix itself. Our second property tells us that the inverse of the product AB is equal to B inverse times A inverse. Note that the order of the multiplication reverses. Recall that this is similar to when we learned what AB transpose was equal to. This was equal to B transpose, A transpose. So AB inverse is just like this. Our third property tells us that the inverse of the transpose is the transpose of A inverse. Our last property tells us that the inverse of the scalar multiple R times A is equal to 1 over R, since R is a scalar, times A inverse. Let's now use these properties to simplify some matrix expressions. In the examples below, the capital letters represent n by n invertible matrices, and we're asked to simplify the following matrix expressions. In our first example, we'll work from left to right and simplify the first expression and then the second expression. Our first expression is equal to A inverse C inverse because we have to switch the order. And then our second expression is equal to C transpose transpose times B transpose. We also switch the order for those. Working from left to right, this gives us A inverse C inverse. And then C transpose transpose is equal to C. And then we have B transpose. We now have A inverse times C inverse times C, which is the identity matrix, times B transpose. This then gives us the expression A inverse B transpose. The identity matrix is just like multiplying by 1, so we don't need to write it down. This is the most simplified form of this expression. Let's now look at our second example. In this one, we also have two expressions. So again, we'll work from left to right. In our first one, we have three matrices that are multiplied and we're taking the transpose. We're going to do this just like we would if we had two matrices. We're just going to reverse all of the orders. So this gives us C transpose, B transpose, A transpose. And then on the right, we have the inverse, so we have to reverse those. So we first have A transpose inverse, and then C inverse. This gives us C transpose, B transpose. And then notice that A transpose times A transpose inverse is equal to the identity. And then we have C inverse. Just like our first example, we're not going to write down the identity. And our final answer becomes C transpose, B transpose times C inverse. Now that we know how to simplify matrix expressions, we can use what we just learned to solve matrix equations. In the examples below, we're going to let the capital letters represent n by n invertible matrices. We're then asked to solve the following matrix equations for X. Let's look at our first example. Our goal is going to be to isolate X on the left-hand side. So the first step that we want to do is to get rid of matrix B. To do that, we can multiply both sides of the equation by B inverse. Let's go ahead and do that. We have B inverse times B times X plus A inverse is equal to B inverse times C. Notice that we're multiplying by B inverse on the left for the left side of the equation, which means we also have to multiply by B inverse on the left for the right side of the equation. The order that you multiply matrices matters. On the left, we're going to get the identity matrix from B inverse B, and then we have X plus A inverse, and that's equal to B inverse times C. We don't need to write down the identity, so we have X plus A inverse is equal to B inverse C. You can actually skip the second step if you don't want to write down I. Now, to isolate X, we're first going to isolate X plus A. So to do that, we have to take the inverse of the inverse. So we're going to take the inverse of both sides of the equation. On the left, this just gives us X plus A. And on the right, we have to switch the order. So we have C inverse times B inverse inverse. Let's go ahead and write down that this is just C inverse B, because the inverse of an inverse is just the matrix. Now we're almost there. All we have to do is move A to the right-hand side. This gives us X is equal to C inverse B minus A. And that's our final answer. Let's look at another example. You might want to stop the video and see if you can complete this one on your own. We need to solve for X, so let's begin by moving A to the right-hand side. On the left, we have BXC inverse, and then on the right, we have D minus A. Now we have to isolate X, and we can do that two ways. We can first multiply on the left by B inverse, or we can first multiply on the right by C. I tend to like working from left to right, so I'm going to choose to multiply each side from the left by B inverse. B inverse times B is the identity, so that just gives us X C inverse on the left, and then we'll copy down what we have on the right. Now to isolate X, all we have to do is get rid of the C inverse, and we can do that by multiplying on the right by C. So on the right-hand side of the equation, we also have to multiply on the right by C. C inverse times C is the identity, so we're left with X on the left, and then B inverse times D minus A times C on the right. And that's our final answer. I think the biggest thing to remember when you solve matrix equations is to make sure that the way you multiply on the left is the same way that you multiply on the right. Be sure to check out the next video in this series, where we'll learn all about the invertible matrix theorem. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.